through some of the things that you want to work through if you've recently had an ankle sprain. One of the biggest things that tends to happen after an ankle injury is we start to develop a little bit of stiffness through the ankle, especially in that maximal dorsiflexed or knees over toes position.
So one way to start working on this a little bit is with a self-banded ankle mobilization.
So what we want to do
is have that band placed just below the ankle joint to stabilize everything through your foot, and then just gently working into this lunge position. So we're getting a little bit of stretch through the calf, as well as getting a little bit more mobility in through that ankle. Important to keep some pressure into your heel while you do this, so that we are actually getting the joint to move and not just taking pressure off of it as we go through this movement. Next thing that we want to get a lot of work on is some of your balance. So working a little bit of single leg balance is a good place to start, but as that gets a little bit easier, we want to add a little bit of instability and extra challenge to this. So you can use something like a half Bosu or a foam pad or a pillow or anything like that at home just to challenge your balance a little bit in some of these positions, so that we need to work on some of those small corrections at the ankle. And if you want to make those even a little bit tougher, it's worth doing a little bit of this with your eyes closed to make it even a little bit harder from there. Besides just static balance, we also want to work a little bit of balance in dynamic positions. One exercise that we really like to use for that is the single leg deadlift or arabesque, which just involves going through a slight hip hinge movement on one leg. So we have consistent changes of your center of mass and working through some dynamic balance in these types of positions. Another thing we really like to do a lot of is working through some band resisted and assisted jumps and downs. And so what these will do is give you a little bit more resistance to move through, so you make sure you get a strong lift, but also making sure that you can absorb more as well. So for example, if you're going into a lateral bound here, then it's going to be pulling us towards the inside, so that ankle needs to stabilize the landing, or pushing away from that, we need to generate a little bit more power with the ankles. And you can do these going left and right, and also working on going forward and backwards and controlling your landings and those type of movements. One more thing that's worth working through is getting into a little bit of hopping or skipping, just so that we can make sure that the ankles have retained a good bit of that ability to sort of bounce and get a bit of force absorption and propulsion from them. This can be as simple as working into a little bit of light hopping. If that's something that feels too difficult to you for you from the start, you can do a little bit of a band assisted work from here, so that the band will help you and reduce a little bit.